Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera and welcome to the Sin Bincang Selasa right here on the Cobra Rugby Club Facebook page. Saya Rashid Saleh dan bersama saya seperti biasa ialah Dilan daripada Cobra Club dan pada hari ini kita ada tetamu yang istimewa. Dia bukan sahaja seorang daripada Cobra Rugby Club, Cobra Legend, tetapi he has made a very good name for himself in the course of the last 15 years or so. He's a one man, I have to stress this, he's a one a club man, has played for Cobra for a long, for the longest time. He still is a part of the Cobra family, apart from, you know, sekolah tu sekolah lah. But he has made a name himself, especially in the world of education and sports education. So let's welcome him into the show. He's a Timbalan Dekan of Science, Sukan and Rekreasi at UiTM Shalam now. UiTM Shalam and also Cobra Legend. Let's welcome Prof. Madia. Prof. Madia, tau, Dr.
Madia. Oh, Madia.
Oh, Dr. Malan lah. Or Malan, as we call him.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Terima kasih kerana sudi bersama kami pada petang ni. Walaupun ada, saya dengar ada appointment yang telah di-cancelkan sebab harus datang ke Sin Bincang, yeah, kan?
Untuk you guys, kena cancel lah. Cobra.
Cobra dulu. Tengok baju kat belakang tu pun baju Cobra juga. Tengok belakang tu. So anyway, for those who don't know you, yang because we know you very very well, tapi cerita yang yang bukan kata tak senonoh lah, but the wild stories akan disimpan di luar lah, because okay. I think not many two wild stories about you because you were such a good boy, but never mind lah. Tapi untuk penonton di luar, bagaimana Doc bermula main ataupun berminat dengan rugby?
Rugby. Okay, I started playing rugby when I was standard 6, darjah 6, dari sekolah King Edward 7 school, then become a project untuk sekolah menengah King Edward 7 school, then I seriously play rugby for club since Form 4, okay. There was I used to play for Penang All Blues masa tingkatan 4 lah, tingkatan 4, used to play for Penang All Blues. I used to play for Taiping Tigers, okay. Then after finish my Form 5, my first club was BBMB Knights, okay. BBMB Knights from KL. Then baru I main UiTM Lions.
Yep.
I joined Cobra after I finished my come back from Commonwealth Games 2002. Itulah. Okay. Then Cobra is only my club. That's all. Then I complete my rugby life from Cobra lah actually.
Tapi dari Cobra, you join selection for national team sekali kan, untuk main negara, mewakili pasukan negara rugby ya?
Yeah. I started play for national when I was 19 years old. 19 years old. There was under 19. After under 19, my first cap for senior team when I was 20 years old. Okay, 20 years old. There was a Hong Kong Sevens tournament. Then altogether 34 caps for Malaysia in international tournaments lah. 34 caps, yeah. Then including Commonwealth Games and Asian Games, World Barbarian Sevens in Papua New Guinea, and few World Seven Series. I used to play against All Blacks three times. Right.
Tapi tak pernah menang lah. Tapi great experience.
Almost
tackle ke almost win. tapi I nak tanya, why did you join Cobra?
Why? Okay, you know what? Cobra is something like macam it's a real club. It's a real club. It's a rugby club. So everything ada. So because last time I rasa macam I bagus, okay? I rasa macam I bagus. So you baru balik daripada Commonwealth kan? So you rasa macam standard you okay. Your standard macam ni, so you should play club yang macam ni. That's why I choose Cobra. Sebab everything so complete, training session macam mana, so dia ada, in fact dia ada few tokens when you turun for training semua kan. And the environment of the apa nama training tu memang lain daripada lain lah sebenarnya. Sebab tu I rasa macam okay, Cobra is the best club for me to join this club, you know, at that time. Yep.
So bila dah join tu macam mana standard pula? Are you still one of the better ones ke atau tiba-tiba alamak aku banyak kerja lagi ni?
Yeah. I tak pernah regret. I rasa macam okay. So training dia macam ni dengan coach masa tu Mr. Boone, right? Mr. Boone masa tu. Then training memang proper training, equipment semua complete. Okay, training pun hard training. So I suka macam tu. I suka macam tu because rugby is something like macam contact sport kan. So contact sport you kena betul-betul ni lah. So even training pun few of players yang berdarah kan, kepala berdarah, berjahit pun ada kan. So benda-benda macam tu yang macam I love the apa kata, the environment of the training tu sebenarnya. Okay, I tak suka macam bila last time bila you pergi training, you just play touch apa semua tu, no. So training rugby, tackle, so club, I rasa macam Cobra ni, you punya training touch sekejap saja. Masa tu lah, touch sekejap saja. Then the rest all about tackle, hit, run and benda tu yang I suka lah.
Kalau dari segi tournament ke apa, which year was probably one of your yang ada kenangan manis ataupun pengalaman yang best experience, which year?
So join Cobra or National? Cobra. Obviously Singapore 10s, yeah? No, Singapore 7s, sorry. Yeah, Singapore 10s or 7s? SEC 7s. Yeah, SEC 7s. SEC 7 was my first cap dengan Cobra lah actually. Okay. So dia punya ada apa ni, how Cobra organize dia punya team tu memang fantastic lah. Okay, in fact di Singapore pun everything's all cantik, flow cantik, then I feel like macam like professional player lah at that time. So even team pun memang very strong, cuma unlucky lah few games kalah tu because of some simple mistake dan kalah. Otherwise, I think boleh masuk, boleh lagi pergi jauh, semifinal probably. Masa tu lah, okay. It was 2003 or something, 2003 or 2000. Yeah,
Doc, when rugby is a game, size too matters.
Yeah.
Dan badan Doc tu kira small size lah to compare majority of players. Tu bagaimana, how's bagaimana dia menjadi halangan ke atau memang halangan, tapi bagaimana Doc mengatasi halangan ni?
It's come from here, man. Come from here. I don't care who you are, man. So when you play rugby, it's a contact sport. You just whack. Okay, to me, you choose to play rugby, so you have to, you gonna all out lah. Because kalau you takut, then you main other sports. Okay, rugby something like macam contact sport. Contact sport, you have to do 120%. In terms of the contact and so on lah. So that's why you have to prepare mentally, kan? Mentally, physically, you kena really really prepare because you the one who choose to play rugby. So bagi I macam tu lah, because I play rugby because I have goals. I have goal in rugby. I have a dream in rugby. I want to be someone in rugby. Contohnya, you know what my ultimate dream dalam rugby itu apa? I want to play against All Blacks. Okay, I want to play against All Blacks. So because I dengar All Blacks ni macam kuat sangat dulu kan. So, okay, fine. I just want to try to play against them. And the second one is to play in Commonwealth Games lah. Okay, Commonwealth Games, the highest tournament. Okay, Yeah. See, if you look at the picture again, normally two or three players try to tackle one All Blacks, yeah? One Kiwis. But the pictures show that two Kiwis try to tackle one small boy from Malaysia. Come on, man.
Nice.
Right. So okay, what does that mean? What does that mean, Dylan?
It means
apa maksud dia tu? Two Kiwis try to tackle one small boy.
That means your presence tu besar lah. The presence is big. The body may be small, but your presence is big.
Yeah, man. I don't care who they are, man. They play for their country. I play for my country, right? They play for New Zealand, I play for Malaysia. That's all.
Okay. Also, dengan national team, I mean, we had people like Ujang who's on the team as well. So, tapi our national team at that time was not tall but fast.
Yeah.
Tapi was that something that was kalau kiranya kita bandingkan dengan Southeast Asia, were we still one of the best then?
That time, itu masa gambar lawan dengan Thailand. In Thailand, I think. Unfortunately, kita kalah sikit lah. Tapi team masa tu kuat sebenarnya, Rashid and Dylan. So most of the players, I baru 20 years old. Tapi most of the players tu memang experienced players. 98 punya team Sukan Commonwealth kan. So itu. Tapi entahlah, boleh kalah juga masa tu.
Tapi masa tu Jude teammate lah kan?
Jude tak ada lagi dah masa tu.
Pain is temporary, glory lasts forever.
Yeah,
inspirational
man.
Quote. But itu satu pengalaman ya. Masa tu kalau kira satu pengalaman ya. Kalau tapi that one memang tak ada regret ya, that game.
Nah, you know what, Dylan? I want to share something. How I want to increase my confidence. Bila game World 7 Series macam tu, I want to share something here. Okay, you know what? Siapa yang tahu, yang teammate saya mungkin ada tahulah. Okay. So normally bila di hotel tu, so during masa breakfast, normally masa breakfast, I akan tunggu All Blacks player turun tau. All Blacks player turun, because bila All Blacks player turun, most of the players lain-lain daripada country lain, dia akan tengok All Blacks. Okay, who? Siapa dia? Oh, Kartana, oh, Amasu Valens, all this, Eric Raj. Okay, so you know what? I akan buat apa tau? I akan tunggu diorang queue untuk ambil makanan, breakfast. I akan masuk celah-celah tu. I akan join them queue untuk ambil makanan, breakfast lah. Right? So at the same time, orang akan tengok All Blacks plus orang akan tengok I juga. You know what I mean? Okay? So bila tengok macam tu, so I feel like okay, fine, people look at me. So at the same time, confidence I can increase masa tu. So that's why bila I dah masuk stadium main, I rasa no, okay, I'm just like them. I macam diorang je. Tak ada rasa macam rendah diri ke, tak ada. Okay, so I macam diorang, then I just play. Okay. Itu cara, salah satu cara yang I buat to increase my confidence lah. That's why sekarang I sport psychology. So I give some tips about that. Yeah.
Which is why it's leading me to that question. What made you decide to go into sports psychology?
Yes.
Was it because of the yang pengalaman you ada, yang you belajar daripada national team and as a player? Is that something that when did you start that?
Because I have this method, we call it practice in mind. Okay, Dylan tahu, the practice in mind. Okay, you know what? One of the reason why some athlete dia takut bila main, dia nervous, apa bila tengok team yang kuat-kuat, especially in rugby, dia tengok team yang kuat-kuat, dia takut. Okay, sebab apa? Because of mentally is not ready yet. Okay, so I have this theory. So this theory try to make sure that whatever situation yang you akan face, you train first dalam mind you. You have to train first in your mind. That's why we call it practice in mind. So you tengok everything semua, try to play in your mind, then keluarkan during the competitions. Okay, apa yang I buat macam dengan Oblex, ya? I akan tengok dia punya training dulu. I akan pergi training session ni di Padang before game tu, or one day before. So tengok dia training macam mana, okay, fine. So I try to recall, I try to feel that macam I tengah training dengan orang, I tengah game dengan orang. Then I just play on my own. So the next day tu, during tournament, baru I keluarkan benda tu, then I tak rasa takut pun. I just main je because I'm ready now. In your mind. So this is what we call it, practice in mind to learn and write.
So how did it take yang berapa lama you belajar yang step ni, at least okay. What did you have to go through to do all this?
Okay, sebenarnya I suka dream tu. I ni orang kata apa, kalau bahasa tu kita panggil apa, suka berangan. I suka berangan dari kecil lagi, I berangan tu, you know. I berangan nak macam ni, I berangan nak want to play for New Zealand. I berangan nak nak main untuk di Commonwealth Games. I berangan nak main, I berangan nak ada PhD, I berangan nak jadi professor. So berangan ni daripada awal lagi. So, when you have the dream, you kena cari the strategy how to achieve the dream. Okay? That's why I play with the strategy. So until I achieve my dream lah, macam tu. So benda tu memang sentiasa dalam fikiran I. Whatever yang I buat, you have to come up with the strategy in order for you to achieve the dream. So itu I punya style. Okay, benda tu yang I bercerita dengan all my students, blah blah blah. So you must have goals, you must have dream. You bukan buat degree in sports lah, macam tu saja. You must have something. You kena ada apa. Alright, even in sports. You represent Malaysia in Tokyo, for example, Olympic, kan? Right? You just nak pergi sana untuk for fun ke apa? Right? You must have dream. Okay, you nak improve punya ranking, for example, ataupun dapat medal, right? So you kena ada tu. Then you kena come out with the strategy how to achieve the goal. It's very simple. Itu my style.
Bagaimana macam para yang apa semua Olympian yang memang dia pasal tahun ni 2020 Tokyo Olympics dah ditunda, kan? So bagaimana semua atlet sekarang ni nak, bagaimana strategi, apa yang nasihat pada, atau how do you adjust the strategy kalau sekarang dah terpaksa duduk rumah, facilities okay, tak boleh, tak ada access.
Yep. So basically macam I involve dengan Farah N, eh.
Farah, oh, nak tanya.
More to gymnastic, gym lama, no, artistic gymnastic. Okay. Apa yang I advise, target tetap sama, okay. Target tak ada macam like when MCO ataupun COVID-19, your target from contohnya daripada silver medal down to bronze medal, tak ada, eh. So target tetap sama, silver medal. Okay, ranking, you want to improve ranking, tetap same. But how you gonna improve this? Based on training. So it doesn't matter PKP ke, COVID-19 ke, whatever, you have to train. Why? Because target tetap sama. Dia tak ada berubah. The same goes to because I involved with wilayah persekutuan team untuk Sukma, kan? So I have to control all the apa sports, okay? So every day I'm with them in terms of the training, psychology training, okay? Online and plus the physical training. Benda sama. So do not stop training. Very simple. Do not stop training because the target tetap sama. You have the target. And you have to think, a good athlete, a good player, you have to think how to manipulate with the situation tu. Training tu, pilih lah. Training, kalau tak boleh training kat luar, then you kena training secara benda lain, kan? Sebab training ada banyak, tactical, technical, physical, psychology. Use all that. Okay, guna semua tu, then try to create the situation tu like a real situation. Okay, even though you tak boleh keluar, you have to create the environment, the situation tu like a real one. Then everything will be okay. Okay, fitness okay, semua okay, semua.
Okay, so dari segi sport psychology, do you think sekarang, zaman sekarang, are we taking, or rather sports as a whole, are we taking sports psychology more seriously? Because kita selalu dengar kelemahan atlet-atlet Malaysia dari segi minda dan juga tu. We always hear it. I will dare say the biggest example is Datuk Lee Chong Wei lah. Dua kali ada peluang untuk memenangi pingat emas, tapi dua kali terjejas because of Lindan. Because you know dia pernah mengalahkan Lindan dalam tournament lain, tapi bila datang ke Olimpik, dua kali dia hampir ke pingat emas. And that's to me probably the best example, even though you know he's been number one in the world itu. Can you explain that for us?
Okay. Datuk Lee Chong Wei punya case issue. Okay, to me apa yang I nampak based on past experience. Okay, past experience. Okay, past experience will influence you for the next, for the future punya game lah. You know, okay. So sometimes Olympic dia pernah kalah dengan the same person. Linda. Okay. So benda tu akan bermain dalam fikiran dia. So when it come to the same tournament, Olympic jumpa Lindan. So benda tu akan bermain. So dia pernah kalah dengan Lindan. So benda tu akan sentiasa bermain dalam fikiran dia kalau dia tak get rid on it. Okay. Sebab apa? Kalau dia main dekat tournament lain, dia boleh je menang dengan Lindan. Okay. Tapi Olympic dia kalah dengan Lindan. It's because of past experience. Past experience tu kalau dia masih lagi tak buang, dia akan bermain. Bila bermain tu dia akan berfikir macam-macam, all the negative thought, blah 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 blah, dia akan kalah. Then even the mistake yang kecil-kecil pun dia akan buat juga. Because of dia dah teringat benda yang lama. Okay, itu atlet punya kelemahan. Because of the same tournament, the same opponent, bermain dalam fikiran dia. The same mistake, right? Okay, the problem now, okay, apa yang paling ketara dari segi psikologi eh? Kita tahu bila kalah aja you blame psychology, betul tak, Brad? You kalah aja you blame psychology. Kalah aja you blame psychology. But you tak train psychology, you don't train. Do you train psychology, Brad? Dylan? No, right?
No.
You don't train psychology. You just okay. Maybe coach sometimes they tahu. Okay, I train my boy psychology. How do you train it? Oh, I give motivation. Oh, come on, you can do it. All this. Now this motivation is motivation talk or pep talk. Okay, psychology you need to be trained. Okay, training lebih kurang macam physical juga. Okay. 5 times training physical dekat Padang, 5 times training psychology. It's very simple. The rules very simple. Okay, so meaning that dalam kejuruan latihan in coaching, you must have you must include all these 4: tactical, technical, physical, psychology, all together train. At the same time. Okay.
Ada contoh apa yang mana sebagai macam untuk for psychological punya training.
Okay, contoh before you pergi, okay, you dah pakai baju, you dah sampai ke Padang, okay, Padang you dah pakai baju semua siap, okay. You jangan masuk lagi Padang. Jangan masuk lagi Padang, you berdiri dulu kat situ, you try to visualize whatever yang you nak kena buat hari ni. Okay, visualize tu, bayangan tu, you kena go skill by skill. For example, thrower. Okay, line out. Hooker, okay, dia kejap lagi dia kena improve dia punya throwing kan. Okay, paling. So, dia kena start visualize benda tu. Try. Okay, dalam visualization tu, timing kena sama. Timing dia kena sama, apa skill-skill yang dia buat masa tu, contohnya dia ada buat breathing technique ke, dia kena include in their mind. Okay, kena masukkan semua dalam fikiran dia. Then, bila dia turun ke padang, dia kena buat benda yang sama. The same time, the same timing. Kalau let's say, kalau dia throw, okay, dia pegang bola apa-apa, okay, dia ambil masa lebih kurang 5 second. Tap, okay, up, throw, okay. In dalam minda dia, dalam mind dia kan. So dekat fizikal pun dia kena buat benda yang sama, 5 second juga. Faham tak? Okay. So apa yang dia tengah visualize tu, masa dia turun ke padang, buat secara fizikal, dia kena sama. Okay, kalau tak sama, something wrong. Psychology. Something wrong with the psychology. So meaning that dia kena sense about psychology. Maksud dia tu, during imagery tu, during visualization tu, dia kena dia kena add on lah. Breathing technique ke, dia kena buat realization technique sikit ke, sebelum balik tu kan, jangan terlalu, because when you play rugby, you tired kan, letih apa semua, then you jadi macam anxious tau bila nak balik tu, you macam tak tahu nak, you gabra lah apalah sebab kelang kabut eh, tiba-tiba dah kena call, apa nama, captain dah cakap, okay bola dua, you tak ready lagi, by right kena ready, okay, balik you kena ready, then throw. That's why kadang-kadang tu bola tu tak straight lah, bola tu belakang lah. It's because of you're not ready yet. That's why kalau 5 second training. 5 second in mind, 5 second in physical. Okay, benda tu kena consistent lah. Itu cara one of the tips how you train the psychology lah dekat padang.
That's kalau kita rajin training, kalau kita training latihan physical, kita kena rajin juga. Dari segi psychological pun kena rajin practice semua ni lah kan?
Yes. Itu yang sekarang saya tengah promote the whole Malaysia, apa itu practice mind. And alhamdulillah benda tu dah jadi rutin most of the athletes in Malaysia lah. Okay, because this is something new. They know psychology important. Okay, coach tahu, satu dunia tahu. Important tak psychology? Oh, very important. Alright. Tapi how you train psychology? How to train psychology ya? Alright. They have to call Dr. Malan.
Sebab tu Profesor Madia, Doktor.
Oh my god.
So, poster ni lah. Nombor dah ada 0120016915. Call dia, tengok dia tunjuk kat mana, kat kepala.
Yes, it's all in your mind.
Saya masih ingat, kalau siapa ingat masa main rugby, untuk kita bukan first, masa saya main bukan first team lah, saya making second team. Tapi masa second team pasal kita punya mental strength tu is high. Walaupun team lain lagi bagus, tapi kita boleh menang pasal kita punya mental strength kuat untuk kita boleh tahan 80 minit. Mana setengah team je tak tahan 80 minit.
Yep. So bezanya dulu Cobra dengan team lain zaman tu, saya rasa lah, bukan, it's not, I think because we're better physically, especially yang battle yang kita, apabila kita main dengan Royal Selangor Club yang diorang paling besar lagi kan, but mental strength, we know that we were strong. What do you think, why was that masa tu?
Okay, one thing about Cobra, you know what, because kita train exactly like apa yang kita nak keluarkan masa a real situation tau. Kita train harder, kita tackle, kita bangun berdarah, everything semua. Alright? So benda tu penting. Why? It's because of you nak jumpa orang yang kuat. So you kena train harder masa tu. Kita tak main tap. Yeah? Kita tak main tap masa tu. Okay? During that time memang I tengok macam Mr. Boon punya session tu memang okay sekejap je, then all fitness then tackle, okay buat empat team, then main walk B tackle everything semua kan. This is what the real rugby, you know, because you nak main okay macam ni, then you ke train macam tu, you kena sama, alright, feeling yang sama, enjoy during training, okay, bila game pun you akan enjoy, seriously. Okay, bila training you enjoy, you fun with your teammate. Bila game, obviously you akan menang. Why? The same feeling ada kat situ. This is what you want. But most of the athlete now, dia training enjoy. Tapi bila game, dia stress. Itu yang dia kalah. Okay, so maksud kat sini, dia kena train, dia kena bawa all the feelings tu. All the feelings, emotion during training, apa semua tu. Bawa ke competition, then baru dia boleh menang.
Okay, tapi yang kataan enjoy tu, zaman sekarang dia beza sikit. Bila dia enjoy, dia memang relax enjoy, bukan training enjoy tau. So yeah, I just have to explain that to the audience out there lah. Sebab dulu kita enjoy memang kita sebab kita nak enjoy main rugby, bukan enjoy sebab kita kat padang. But moving forward daripada segi sports psychology, do you think it should be taught in from a younger age? Dari umur berapa kita sepatutnya kita belajar sports psychology, or at least psychology, but sports psychology in this case?
Okay, psychology, the moment dia decide nak involve in sports, masa tu dia kena start dah training psychology, because masa tu dah start component of coaching, kan? Component of coaching dah ada kat situ. You start with the theory, then come up with the physical, come up with the tactical, technical and psychology. These five elements from theory tu, five elements tu kena work together, work together. Trust me, kalau benda-benda ni okay, inline, cantik, world class level. Okay. Pergilah lawan mana-mana pun, jumpalah siapa-siapa pun dekat depan you, menang. Why? Daripada awal you train benda tu. Okay, the five tu. Theory, physical, tactical, technical and psychology all together. Okay. Other, the sports science yang lain tu, you top up je. Like nutrition, sports injury, all the knowledge kan. Performance analyst, apa lagi, physio, apa semua tu, it's all about. Itu semua top up je. Okay. Contohnya, kalau you nak improve technical, you kena perlukan biomechanics to help. You perlukan motor learning punya knowledge to help on this. You perlukan performance analyst to check you punya movement. Okay. Itu semua top up. Tapi the basic theory tu kena ada kat situ. The basic punya asas punya in rugby semua kan kena ada. The five tu. Five element tu kena cantik. Alright. Contohnya kalau.
Five element, boleh ulang sekali.
Theoretical, kalau daripada awal lah. Daripada awal tu, theoretical dia kena tahu basic swing, basic apa semua tu. Then tactical, technical, physical and the psychology. All these five work together daripada kecil sampai besar, world class level guys.
So, okay. you kena, Malan, you sekarang ni you kena kena trademark the sports five senses. Five element of sports. You kena trademark tu dah sekarang.
Yeah, should be. Masalahnya kadang-kadang coach dia tak percaya benda tu. Itu masalah dia. Right, dia tak percaya. Dia tahu dia, aku pernah menang dulu lah. Aku tak guna pun benda ni semua. I don't use all this sports science pun. Right? So benda gila.
Betul kan? They want pakai tapi dia tak faham that they have been using it themselves tapi tak tahu macam mana nak translate tau. Tapi okay. People like you, that's why I said yang you guna, yang you pakai dulu, it's the same thing. Now we are, you know, we have put a word to it lah. Okay, this is going to be the hard bit. So kalau ada, for example, sebab kita selalu bila ada tournament je, baru ni lah nak training. What's the minimum time? What is there a minimum time for getting ready in the mind, practice okay. In the mind?
So kita ada preparation kan. So a good team ataupun persatuan yang bagus, dia kena ada preparation dia. Okay, bila dia punya transition phase, bila dia punya tournament competition phase, semua tu lah. So by right, 1 year just nice lah for the whole year, dan bergantung juga bila tournament tu, right? So basically 1 year tu okay. Kalau more than 1 year lagi cantik lah, maksudnya daripada awal. Sebab kita perlukan kemahiran, okay, all the skill ni perlukan training selalu tau. You kena train selalu to master the skill. Okay, I tell you the truth, kalau you master the skill ni, contohnya you master nak swing, okay, contoh you nak swing 20 meters you daripada scrum half, contohnya red you scrum half kan, apa
Dylan pun scrum half.
I used to be scrum half juga dulu, okay.
Tahu.
So you nak swing 20 meter, you nak swing 10 meter, you nak swing 5 meter, semua different skill, okay. Wrist macam mana, okay, you punya wrist, you punya follow through, semua tu different. So you kena master on that. Once you master skill tu, psikologi takkan ada masalah. Psikologi takkan ada masalah. Why? Because of you master all the skill. The problem is now, kita skill kita pun belum master lagi, ability kita pun untuk kita swing tu belum tahu lagi. Contoh kita nak swing 20 meter. Tak ada strength. You kena improve punya physical, you kena improve punya strength. Very simple. Okay, so kanan kiri you kena training. Okay, benda tu perlukan latihan. So setahun, dua tahun, tiga tahun benda tu kena sentiasa train. Okay, so kalau kita nak bagi exact time tu, to me kena lagi lama lagi bagus lah. Until you rasa 20 meter, easy. 10 meter, easy. Ini kadang-kadang tu, kawan kat sebelah, 1 meter je, you passing macam you nak passing 10 meter punya swing kan. Then problem lah tu. You don't know how to control benda tu. Betul tak? You learn that right, right? Bagi laju, kawan kat sebelah pun you still bagi laju. So, fumble. Then you marah. Nah, itu kita punya problem. Marah, marah, marah. You tak encourage pun others.
old school.
Okay, come on. Aduh. Then ada main. Kononnya rugby is all about a tough guy play rugby. So kena marah, kena ketuk kepala pun is okay. No way, man.
Okay. Sekarang marah kena kecil hati dah. Okay. No, memang you know, interesting lah though, how you piece, how you put it together, structure, all these things. Yang the takeaway which I read here is that the kalau don't wait for tournament to train. I mean, mana you macam kalau memang you mesti training tu, training ke dari segi physical, mental, semua yang 5 element yang bincang tadi kan, mesti buat secara konsisten. Tak boleh, kita kena buat konsisten, slowly. Lepas bila nak time tournament, okey lah, mungkin kita ramp up. So, memang interesting lah. Memang macam benda ni, kita tak boleh harap nak, bila nak tournament baru kita nak training hard kan?
I want to share something with you. This one. You know what this is? Key to success in sport. Okay, I use, this is Malan. I use Malan. You know what is M? M is measurable. Okay, measurable. Defining the competition and training objective to make it clearer and easier for me to achieve. So, measurable, because my goal to play in Commonwealth Games. Okay, so I punya ultimate dream line dalam rugby. Okay, that's why I stop rugby awal. Okay, Red and Dylan. I stop rugby not because of apa, I just because of I rasa I dah achieve my goal. So measurable, something that I can measure. It's Commonwealth Games, okay, and play against All Blacks. Second is assessment, A, M-A, assessment. Assessment by assessing my performance regularly. So I can assess diri I. I dah ready ke belum lawan All Blacks ni? Okay, I dah ready ke belum lawan pergi Commonwealth Games ni? So benda tu I kena assess diri I kena evaluate diri I macam tu. That's why I main Cobra, so pergi tournament ni, pergi lawan dengan big team, big tournament kan. Kalau if notice kan, Red, during training, kalau Fiji duduk sebelah I ramai, I akan pergi team opponent. Why? Because I nak tackle Fiji, masa tu. I nak try tackle, because I nak check diri I. I'm ready atau tidak lawan dengan orang-orang besar ni. Okay, tu I assess diri I. And I assess diri I from time to time based on tournament. Next is lively. So I train, I enjoy training. Why? Because we have goal in life, in rugby. That's why you can enjoy the training. This the fourth one is acknowledgement. I need this. Puji daripada coach respect you. Wow, daripada kawan-kawan. Okay. So wow, Malan. Hey, how do you do that, man? Oh, nice try. I nak benda tu. Okay, dulu lah masa zaman rugby. Yeah? So I nak benda tu. Why? Because of to improve my performance for the next game. In fact. During game tu pun, I nak orang kata, oi, Malan main ke? Okay, oh, Malan main lah. So, I nak dengar benda tu. Why? Because of to increase my confidence, to improve my performance from time to time. Because why? Because I want to play in the Commonwealth Games. Okay? I tak nak orang kata, you pergi Commonwealth Games, you tak sesuai lah pergi Commonwealth Games, you tak layak lagi. No. That's why I can change this. The last one is nice. Okay? Be nice and will never look down on other athletes, on other players. Okay? So in fact you dah bagus macam mana sekalipun you still baik dengan orang-orang lah, okay. Tapi I normally baik after game lah. After game kita kan Cobra kan, rugby kan. So after game everything's all 0-0. During game enemy man, okay. Okay, but I normally I tak main kasar, I tak main ni, I just psycho people je. Then bila bila I psycho orang, I psycho orang, orang tak boleh main, then people start punch me, people start hijak I semua, then I just smile. Why? Because I'm fit. Then I fit, I can just smile. Kalau I tak fit, sure I bergaduh juga. Right? That's why rugby player, you have to control this. Okay.
Yeah. Ini bukan rugby player, ini
scrum half punya kerja tu. Kerja scrum half dari dulu. Out psycho the opposition. So, yeah. We all did it because besar kecil ke kita selalu kacau dia orang. Cannot, bila dia dah minda dia dah terkacau, then we know that we've won the battle. But that's something that we've learned over the years lah. Yeah. So that's very important.
Semua tips saya guna dulu.
Dari dulu dah. That's why mulut kita selalu we keep talking to the a lot of that was important. But that's in dalam team game lah. Kalau dari segi individual, I know we've all gone over the time, tapi let's go quickly go back to yang kerja yang you buat dengan Farah and Hadi. What was the thing that gets her to that next level? Sebab sebelum ni orang tak percaya. But we know that we need a psychologist to move them to another level. With someone like Farah and Hadi, what did you need to do to bring her to another step up?
Just to add on, sorry, Doc. Now, especially with all the problems with related to the COVID, and there's a lot of restrictions and all that adds on to the problem. Just to add on to it.
Mm-hmm. So, like Farhan punya session, so basically I have to monitor the few session, particularly on the anxiety, self-confidence and self-efficacy plus the performance dia lah, performance. Because dia ada few skill performance yang dia kena rutin yang dia kena buat. So basically I kena check on that to improve dia punya anxiety. For example, kalau dia hesitate untuk jump, for example, so I have to come up with some script. Just to make sure the script tu in line with dia punya routines and routines tu dalam script tu, normally dalam script tu I have to develop the script based on the psychology performance lah, based on performance, and the script must be positive script. Maksud dia script tu tak ada benda-benda yang boleh buatkan dia fikir benda-benda negatif. So we have to train on that. Okay, just to make sure all the script tu jadikan dia punya routine dalam mind dia. Okay, normally itu cara I train athlete. So the same goes to kalau COVID-19 macam ni pun lebih kurang sama. So you dah train for how many years benda yang sama, skill performance sama, skill benda sama je you routine. For example in bowling, okay, you hari-hari you baling bola aje berpuluh-puluh tahun, for example, tapi still masuk longkang, still tak boleh dapat strike. Why? It's because of here, routine tu tak ada dalam fikiran dia. So they keep changing the routine, they keep changing the script. Script tu they keep changing. Some script 7 seconds, some script 9 seconds, some script 5 seconds. So tak consistent. Alright? So benda kena consistent here and consistent physically. It's very simple. Okay guys.
We have it.
Sounds simple, but we need the professor. Professor to show.
Actually yang the reason I brought out this because you tahu lah I juga president MMA Malaysia, so and it's a very young sport.
I can give you a special rate for you, right?
No, definitely. I it's something that we have been planning to do because I know that sports psychology is very important because kita ada athlete yang muda and they need that thing to go forward, but it's something that I will working with Cobra in terms of, you know, rugby and MMA being as one. And yeah, kita tahu lah in our own community, Cobra community family, we have so many good and so many talented and so many experience, whether the players, coaches, psychologists, masseurs. So we're planning to bring the family into the sport because we are all winners kat sini.
Yep.
We've been there, we know what it's been like. So why do we go outside to get people when we know our family, our own family have winners and people who do who've been doing this. So yes, definitely you will be part of that, even though I'm saying in public, but I it will cost, but these costs are you know, very little compared to what the success that we can have as a national side.
Ni Red, dia ikut you punya proses tadi, Dok. Dia sudah berangan, sekarang dia ada strategi, sekarang dia nak
Berangan dari dulu dah. I didn't know in my head when they made me president. I said, oh, Cobra, we have Cobra, we've been success, Cobra. This is the way. Family. So
all right.
It's true.
Agar Ramli dia bilang hi. Mok.
Mok. Okay. Zul, look at. Family.
Mok tak kerja ke? Salam Dr. Mazlan.
Salam Mok. That one Azim is ni kan?
Eugene.
Family.
Ni pun Muhammad Faizal Zakaria.
Zakaria is Tiger. So Mani Sumbra. Mani Nomi Sumbra. Okay.
Then Faiz Lovell, I think dari Indonesia kot.
Bali, from Bali,
yeah.
Bali Development Rugby.
But Faiz girlfriend, Faiz girlfriend.
No. Botak. Good luck, Malan.
Oh, Botak. Yeah.
Yes. But yeah, the session has been really, really good. Thank you very much. Oh, kerja. Dia kata kerja, tapi...
Sure, not more kerja.
Kerja, tapi dekat cubicle masih...
She's saying she's from Bali, eh?
Oh, I thought Faiz girlfriend. No.
No, that's the name lah. Hello.
final words untuk athlete-athlete kita, at least our players out there. What, you know, of course, to look for you lah. I mean, this one I'll put it up again, you know. This is the phone number. Kalau minta bantuan ke apa ke dari segi sports psychology, psychology, to contact you at 012-201-6915. Because, you know, even though we're promoting our own people. Tapi, what's your final, most important thing that you, every athlete, or even coaches, anyone in sports should have?
So please, coaches and all the athletes, so please believe on this psychology as well, okay? Because we train psychology just to make sure that all the four components, coaching, confidence, the one that I mentioned before, in line together. So trust me, when you train psychology, when you train physical, tactical, technical all together, you're gonna be successful, right? Okay. So benda ni penting, because bila you kalah, you blame on psychology. Okay. So after you train psychology, then you know the beauty of how to train psychology benda tu, then we can see some improvement. Trust me, you can see some improvement based on the psychology. Improvements come from the technical and tactical yang you akan buat lepas ni. Alright? And all the best. Just believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Okay? Okay? Don't think something else. Think about your skills and your performance. That's all. Then after game, then you think about something else. Then you start thinking about something else. Am I right, Red? Dylan?
After game, we're definitely thinking of something else. Memang dah.
Don't mention here, okay? Guys, don't mention here, okay? So.
Makan. All right.
Relax. Semua geram dah lepas dah. Semua lepas geram semua.
Rugby convener, Noli, kari kambing. So that's, you know, that's also... lepas tu juga. Anyway, thank you very much Doc for joining us on for you guys out there. I'll put the thing out again. Kalau nak cari bantuan daripada segi psikologi, hubungi talian 012-201-6915 Prof Madia Dr. Mazlan Ismail ataupun Doc Malan, one of our own Cobra legends. But from Dylan and myself, thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you again at the same time, 4 o'clock on Friday for Friday session. If you've got something special, hopefully, for you guys. Thank you very much. Again, Doc. Cobra.
Cheers, buddy.
For you, Doc. Yeah, for you.
Cheers.
Yeah, practice in mind.
Yeah, man. Okay. Cheers.
Okay. Take care.